Next is confidence limit for mean mu. So if we consider a large random sample of size n from an infinite population with mean mu and standard deviation sigma, then the sample mean x bar is asymptotically normal as n is tending towards infinity. Okay. Now, what is large in this case? Now, for practical purposes, we are considering any sample with size more than 30 as a large sample. Let's find out how to calculate the confidence interval for mean mu. Now, from the table, from the standard normal probability curve, okay, from that particular normal distribution table, we know that if our level of confidence is 0.95, then the standard normal variate is going to lie between -1.96 and +1.96. Okay, so let's look at this first. Now this is our table. Now the area in between -1.96 and +1.96. So suppose this is my curve. The area between -1.96 and +1.96. Again, since we have only right hand side values, let's calculate this and then we'll double it. Since both the values are going to be same. So the area from 0 to 1.96. Okay, so we have, here we have 1.96. Okay. 0.4750. So this is 0.4750, okay? And again this will be 0.4750. So the entire area, this complete area after adding this will be 0.95, right? So the area between these two is going to be 0.95. similarly, if we are looking for 99, so the area between -2.58 and +2.58 will be 99. Now this is for standard normal variate. Okay, so this interval is for standard normal variate z, but we need confidence interval for mean mu. Now since we know that normal variate can be written as x bar minus mu upon sigma into root of n, let's look at the first one. So I'm going to replace this normal variate with this value. This is less than equals to 1.96, which is equals to 0.95. okay, now what we can do is we can just multiply this. So this can be written as, again, or simplified as -1.96 sigma upon root n is less than equals to x bar minus mu is less than equals to 1.96 sigma upon root n, which is equals to 0.95. further, we can, since we need value of mu, okay, what we can do is, again, we can further simplify this. And so we can write this as -1.96 sigma upon root n minus x bar less than equals to minus mu less than equals to 1.96 sigma upon root n minus x bar. Right? And which is equals to 0.95. Since I don't want negative mu, let's multiply it by negative sign. So now if I'm multiplying by negative sign, this can be written as +96 root n. This will be plus x bar greater than, sign will also change. So this will be mu -1.96 sigma upon root n plus x bar, which is equals to 0.95, right? Again, we can just rearrange this, or I'm taking this x bar here less than or equals to x bar plus 1.96 sigma upon root n, which is equals to 0.95. So for mu, the confidence interval is x bar minus 1.96 sigma upon root n and x bar plus 1.96 sigma upon root n. So this is the confidence interval for mean mu. Similarly, if level of confidence is 0.99, okay, your confidence limit is going to be, okay, for alpha equals to 0.01, then if our level of significance is 0.01, level of confidence will be 99, right? Level of confidence. That is 1 minus alpha is going to be 0.99, right? So in that case, your area under the curve varies from minus 0.258 to plus 258. Okay, so again you have to follow the same procedure, and the interval what we'll get is x bar minus 2.58 sigma upon root n less than or equals to mu, and x bar plus 2.58, okay, into sigma upon root n, which is equals to 0.99. So in this case, if your level of confidence is 0.99, the interval for confidence will be x bar minus 2.58 sigma upon root n and x bar plus 2.58 sigma upon root n. Okay. Now since we know this, we can directly use these values to find level of confidence. Now we have to use this in case our level of confidence is 0.95, and this interval in case our level of confidence is 0.99.